Hey Lars, thanks for watching, and I want to wish you a very safe and happy recovery. And from the producers of Dr. Payam Show and Blackpen Redpen, we just wanted to say that our hearts and prayers are with you. And I'm sure the subscribers feel the same way too. With that said, gute Besserung, und ich weiß, dass du bald sehr glücklich sein willst. Thank you very much.
Okay, as we all know, whenever we have x squared plus bx plus c equal to 0, that's just a typical quadratic equation. But this right here has y double prime, also y prime, also y. This right here is called the Cauchy Euler Differential Equation, and it's also called the equidimensional differential equation. Today, I'll show you guys how to solve this with all the three cases that you have to know. First of all, let's make some observation. As you all know, we have ax squared times y double prime, and then this right here. You see, you have to differentiate the function and multiply by x to the first power and also the b. And then right here, this is just the original function times some constant. Altogether, when you add them up, you do a 0 right here, right? So that means the functions and their derivative have to be somehow related. They cannot be too crazy, huh? So let's make some observation right here. Let me give you guys an example. Suppose you start with y equal to a power function, that's x to the fourth power, and we can differentiate this, no problem, right? Differentiate this, we get 4x to the third power, and then do it again, we get 12x to the second power. Great, but check this out. I'm going to multiply this right here by x squared, and we'll end up with 12x to the fourth power, and then I will multiply this by just x, and then we'll get 4x to the fourth power. And notice, you can combine like terms just like the good old algebra days. This is going to give you 16x to the fourth power. And guess what? If you multiply this right here by negative 16, you will end up with negative 16x to the fourth power. And guess what? I just gave you guys an example of a Cauchy Euler differential equation. Why? Because if you add this and that together, you will end up with 0. So check this out. We will end up with x squared times y double prime plus x y prime and minus 16y, this right here will be equal to 0 because everybody will add up to 0 right here on the right hand side. Now the question is this. Given this, suppose you had to solve this on your final exam, how are you supposed to know that x to the fourth power is a solution to this differential equation? And also, are there any other solution to this differential equation? And most importantly, how can we write the general solution for this differential equation, right? Well, don't worry, I'll show you. But the observation right here tells a really important point. That is, y should be a power function, x to some power r, because this will work out nicely, isn't it? I don't know if that's the case. Let's go ahead and figure that out. Suppose I will start with, let's say, the general form, y is equal to x to the r's power. Well, in this case, I will differentiate this twice. Well, the first derivative is going to be r times x to the r minus 1 power, and then the second derivative, y double prime. Don't forget to bring this to the front, and also that r, so it's r times r minus 1, and then minus 1 for the exponent, so we get x to the r minus 2 power, like this. And then you'll see that we'll just put this and that into this and that, and we'll come up with a nice equation. You will see. First of all, let me just write down ax squared times y double prime, which is this. So I'll just put down r times r minus 1 times x to the r minus 2 power. And then next, we have plus bx times y prime, which is this, which is rx to the r minus 1. And then lastly, we have plus c times y, which is just c and then x to the r's power, like this. And everybody right here should be equal to 0. And now notice that everybody has, you see, this times that is actually just x to the r's power because this is 2 plus r minus 2, right? So it's just x to the r's power. Likewise, this and that is just x to the r's power. And of course, lastly, you already have x to the r's power. So nice, huh? And with that being said, we can just factor that out. Let's just go ahead and factor out the x to the r's power. Can we? Sure, we can. And then let's see what will happen. Inside here, notice we have ar, don't forget to distribute, so ar times r, we get ar squared, and ar times negative 1, just minus ar, and then next we have br, so plus br, and lastly right here we have plus c, and altogether this right here should be equal to 0. And you see, here we have this equation, and check this out. This right here I am not going to look at because there's no such r, so that you can put in there, and then you can make this equal to 0 all the time. It depends on x for, just don't look at it, okay? This is the main part you have to look at. So we will want this right here to be equal to 0. And of course, you see this and that together, we can just compile like terms. So with that being said, we can write this down, namely ar squared, and this and that, because both of them have the r, so I'll factor that out. I will get minus a plus b, and then put the r right here, and then we have the plus c, and this right here shall be equal to 0. This right here is a condition on the r that will make that differential equation true. Well, this right here has a name, it's called the characteristic equation. The r equation, again, the condition on r will make this right here true. And you see, this right here is actually just a quadratic equation because you have the r squared and also r to the first power, there's no r. It looks different than the original one, but it's still kind of cool. Because this is the quadratic equation, we have three cases to study. Here we go, case one. We have to look at the solutions, right? Case one is that, let's just say we have r1 and r2. Well, suppose they are both real and they are different. So I'll just say r1 is not equal to r2. Again, they are both real, and suppose they are the solution to this, right? In that case, you are going to be using the following. You just use, well, as I said earlier, x to the r's power is a solution to this right here in the general form. And then if they are both real and they are not equal to each other, what you're going to do is you will use x to the r1 and also x to the r2. I will call that the building block to the solution to this differential equation. This, again, right here are the building blocks to the solution to this differential equation. Well, case two, as you all know, when you solve a quadratic equation, maybe you end up with two solutions, but actually they are just equal to each other, so you actually just have one. So you just have one r. Let's just say you have r1. Suppose you have r1 is equal to r2. In that case, what you are going to use is the following. First of all, you have to use x to the r1, of course. But next one, remember, you have to have linearly independent solutions. So you cannot just put on, let's say, like c times x to the r1 whatsoever. In this case, it's kind of weird. I will have to do another video on that with a slower pace. But you are going to use x to the r1 times natural log of x right here for the second building block. Again, this and that have to be linearly independent. This and that were linearly independent. And if you have this right here, you are going to multiply by natural log of x, right? Then lastly, case three. Well, the best part is what if r is complex? And in that case, you end up with two complex solutions. And for sure, they will be different, right? So in that case, I will just write r as, let's say, alpha plus or minus whatever. Just say plus. Well, just put on plus minus beta I like this. We have two solutions, right? So the first one is alpha plus beta I. The second one is alpha minus beta I. In this case, this is what you are going to use. So I'll put it down in blue and red, just like Spider-Man. So here we go. We will be using, well, check this out. We will have x, and let's just focus on the alpha and beta right here, right? Well, technically, I will have to put this right here, but as I said, I will just put down, let's say, alpha plus beta I like this. Well, actually, I will prove this on the side right here for you guys. So this right here is my note. So what I'm going to do is, you will see x to the alpha plus beta I, let me just put it down right here for you guys, like this. This right here, of course, you're adding the power, so you can just write this as x to the alpha times x to the beta I. And now, x to beta I is kind of weird. X is supposed to be real, and then, of course, you have a complex exponent. We don't like x being the base. We like to have e as the base. So this is what we do. Look at x as e to the natural log of x. So here we go. This is going to be x to the alpha power. That's good. And then the x right here is, again, e to the natural log of x. But don't forget, you still have this exponent. So you're going to multiply this with that. So it's beta I like this. And now check this out. Because you have the I right here, you see this is e to the I times this and that. And we are going to use the Euler's formula. So remember, e to the I theta is equal to cosine theta plus I sine theta. So we'll use that, but don't forget about this guy, x to the alpha power times all these guys will be cosine of beta ln x. Yes, it's so weird, but this is just how life is. And then plus I times sine beta ln x. And perhaps this right here will give you an idea why we will have the natural log of x over there. And again, this right here is for that, so don't forget to put down another parenthesis if you would like to distribute it, up to you. But here is the deal. Notice that we put down just a plus, right? Alpha plus beta I right here. Technically, you should also do the x plus minus beta I, but let me tell you, they worked out to be the same thing. And you care about the building blocks. And the building blocks that you are going to use is the following. You are not going to worry about the complex part. The I right here. Why? Because this is supposed to be a real differential equation, right? So what you're going to do is you're just going to do this times that. That's your first building block. So I'll just write down x to the alpha power times cosine of beta times natural log of x. This is so crazy. I know we put an x instead of the beta. And then the next building block is this times that. And again, you just ignore the I. And if you want to see why, just request on the not on the denominator, but like whatever. Just in the comment section, we'll ask somebody in the comment section, whatever. And you just do sine times beta times ln x like this. Again, these right here are the building blocks. Why do I say them to be the building blocks? The reason is because you have to multiply c1, c2, and then do the superposition principle. Again, c1, c2, and add them up. c1, c2, add them up, and they will be the general solution to that differential equation according to the situation. So that's pretty much the idea. And of course, I will have to show you guys an example to make you guys happy. So I will show you guys an example to make you guys happy. And this is actually really similar to the second order differential equation with constant coefficient. This right here is not constant coefficient because you have the x squared and also the x. And this is a special case. This is really cool. Well, let me just show you guys an example. I have the example over there. I'm going to show you guys what it is right here. Here is an example. Suppose I want to solve this differential equation. Namely, I want to solve x squared y double prime minus x y prime plus 2y equal to 0. Of course, if you like, and pause the video now and try this out on your own. And you might guess that I will show you guys this kind of situation because this is the hardest one, of course. But anyway, let's go ahead. You can do this and that every single time, or you can just go ahead and put everything right here. You have to know your ABC values, of course. In our case, A is 1, B is negative 1, and C is 2. So you do know your ABC values, right? So you're just going to go ahead and plug into this general form. So we get A is 1, and then we have the R squared plus, well, negative A, so we have negative 1, and plus B, so we have to minus 1, and then we have to have the R, and then plus C, which is 2, like this, and this is equal to 0. Of course, this is just R squared minus 2R plus 2 equal to 0, and this is what we'll do. Let me just subtract 1 on both sides, so we get r squared minus 2r plus 1 equal to negative 1. Why? Because this is a perfect square, and you see that this is r minus 1 squared equal to negative 1. And of course, I'll just take the square root both sides, and don't forget to put on the plus minus. And as you know, this and that will cancel, and of course, we can add the 1 on both sides. So in the end, you get r is equal to 1 plus minus, and of course, square root of negative 1, just write down I for that. So this is pretty much it. So in another word, alpha is equal to 1, and beta is also nicely equal to 1. Lastly, you see, we are going to be using this right here for the building blocks. I will just tell you the solutions. Again, you do C1 times this guy, and again, alpha and beta are just 1. So we will have C1 times x to the first power times cosine of 1 times natural log of x. It's just natural log of x like this, and then we will add. We'll put 1 and 1 there, and don't forget the C2, and then we'll x to the first power, sine, and then beta is 1, and then you have all this like that. So this right here is the general form to the solution, general solution to this differential equation, and this is it. Hopefully you guys all like this video. I went over this pretty quickly because I think this is so cool, right? And yeah. Leave a comment down below if you guys have any questions. And if you guys are new to my channel, be sure to subscribe. Thank you guys so much. As always, that's it. I will do more examples for you guys later on. But so cool, huh? Bye.